सीरियसली
पूरा पैर नहीं रहा है। तू बल के ना
नहीं लग पता
हां
वेट है ना तू जो चल रहा है ठीक है
ब्रेकिंग फ्रंट ओके बैक ने यूज चले बट फ्रंट इज ओके
एबीएस नहीं है
हां मेरे बैक में कैसे है तेरे लिए ब्रेक्स
पूरा पॉइंट है ना दबा रहा
हूं हां
दबा रहा हूं पूरा टाइम उठ जा रहा है पॉइंट है
हां ऑलराइट ఫీల్ ఉంది మచ్చా సీరియస్ చెప్తాన్నా క్రూజ్ అరౌండ్ 5,000-6,000 ఆర్పిఎం 80-90 ఆరాంగా పోతుంది ఏ రికార్డ్ అవుతుందా चल चल Okay, fine. Now let's ride the CB300R. Oh my god. This bike, man, this bike is very, very, very special. It's very close to my heart because this was launched exactly when I bought my CBR250R. And I didn't have the money to buy this bike. So I went with the CBR250R because I was still in my first year of engineering and whatever the earnings I did till my first year of engineering in my part time job, going to the work in the holidays, whatever I had I put it out. So including everything I had 1 lakh. So I was only trying to buy an Apache RTR 160 or an X-Blade, that kind of a motorcycle. But at this, but when I was researching about bikes, this bike was launched. Oh my god, I really, really felt in love this in this bike. But Honda being Honda, the price is so high, man. It's the price is like 3.2 or 3.3 lakhs for the BS4 version. But the quality of the bike was amazing. It is so good. The quality of the bike is so, so good. So I felt like the bike was worth the price, but I didn't have the money to buy. So what I did was, being a middle class boy and having these kind of issues, whatever the money I had earned, I put in CBR250R. That is what I did. So I bought the 250R. That is how it came to in my life. Otherwise, if I had the money, the CB300R would have been in my life. I'll tell you why I like this bike. Because this bike is nothing like any other bike in the India market. This is a 300cc single cylinder, liquid cooled, 6-speed gearbox with 31 bhp and 27.5 Nm of torque. This bike feels like anything, man, but It is so good. Like in the city, if you ride it now, you'll forget every other motorcycle because of its weight. It is 20 kilos lighter than the Duke 390. It is approximately 15 kilos lighter than the Duke 250, and it is 10 kilos lighter than the Duke 200. And it has more torque and more power. It is amazing. This bike is amazing, man. I really, really, really love this bike. Like I have no words that explains the love towards this bike from my side. If I have to nitpick, this bike has poor, what I have to say, excellency, you can say. Of course, this bike, if you have this bike, you are gonna ride it for solo riding. If you are riding it solo, I am telling you, better go this bike. Don't go to 252. Though it is a very good motorcycle in the KTM range, I think that is the best motorcycle you can buy in the KTM range, which is the Duke 250. But this bike, man, CB300R, oh my god, it impresses me whenever I ride this. The pull is instant. Whatever RPM it is, whatever speed it is, the pull is instant, the torque, it is available throughout the rev range. That is the most beautiful thing about this bike. It pulls like crazy at any RPM. It has no power lag whatsoever. And this bike is like smooth as butter. 10 minutes antara, 10 minutes అయిపోయిన కదా ఎట్లా అన్న రాకొని నువ్వు తీసుకొని బైక్ అంతా తర్వాత పోయి ఎడిటింగ్లో ఏమన్నా అయితే చేస్తాను లేకపోతే ఇంక వెళ్ళిపోయేది అట్లే సరేనా పద సో హ్యావ్ టు రికార్డ్ దిస్ వీడియో అగైన్ బికాస్ గోప్రో బీయింగ్ గోప్రో ఇట్ గాట్ స్టక్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ ఐ డోంట్ నో హౌ మచ్ ఇట్ హాస్ బీన్ రికార్డింగ్ బట్ ఏమో బిర్నానే వచ్చేసినాంలే 3:30 వచ్చా ఇంకా టైము అట్లయితే ఇంటికే పోదానులే నేను
ఐ విల్ మేక్ షూర్ టు పుట్ హౌ మచ్ అవర్ ఫుటేజ్ ఇస్ అవైలబుల్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ప్రీవియస్ వీడియో అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ ఓవర్ వ్యూ ఫ్రమ్ మై సైడ్ I'll just summarize this bike because I have already done the video and it did not record, man. Now I don't feel like recording only because the words come out of mouth for the first time are the true words. The second time it becomes like a practice or a correction of the first time what I spoke. Look at him playing with my 250R. I have his CB300R, he is riding my 250R. And it looks amazing when someone rides it. Whenever I see riding my motorcycle from a third person point of view, I think that it is very beautiful, man. It's just like how Yash says in KGF2, Nanna maade ke nam appan kayale agilla, nam appanane yaar kayale agala, something like that. So Honda is like that. They can never make the 250R once again as like they have made it what I have. The headlight is LED, the indicators are LED. I have ridden this bike both in city and on the highway. 400 to 500 kilometers in a day when I went to my native, and also in city for several days, because I have to say, man, this bike impressed me a lot. There is no negative at all apart from the pillion seat comfort, which is okay and good. I very well sufficient for at least for city usage, but for touring and all, no. For touring you can't. It is more of a 1 hour maybe daily commutes. You can use the pillion seat, but not for a touring purpose. If you want a comfortable pillion seat, do not look for this motorcycle. That's all I will say. Listen to the bike! Oh my god! It has this beastly kind of a vibe, this engine. I don't know what Honda thing thought of this engine and made it. It just screams and it just bosses you around like, go! What are you doing with me? You need to go hard. That is the kind of vibe I get from this engine. And it's a very very strong pull. Honestly, this is a very 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 powerful motorcycle. Do not mistake it because it is a 300cc motorcycle. And it has lesser power than the BMW G310R. I'm telling you, this is every bit as powerful as the BMW G310R, and it feels like one. You can easily smoke BMW G310R in terms of quality. The parts in it is amazing. The quality is amazing. Everything is brushed. Everything is very good, very well put together. The gearbox is amazing. I mean, I don't know what else do you want. The gearbox in the BMW G310R is pure shit, man. After few time, the gear lever just jams. I don't know why. I have ridden the BMW G310R which had done about 8,000 or 10,000 kilometers, and that had a pretty shitty gearbox. The shifting was very hard, and the gearbox itself was not so smooth. That was the impression of from my side from on the BMW G310R. But when I rode this, matter of fact, I rode this as the BS6 version itself. I did not ride the BS4 version of this bike. But I have to say, man, this bike deserves an applause from my side and from every owner. Whoever owns this bike, right? They all say the same thing. It is like a tamed beast. It is like a Juke 390 made out of a brand which is known for its smoothness and reliability. So you can expect that this bike will return a very good mileage. This bike will produce very good maintenance cost. I know 3,500 is a very high cost for a 300cc motorcycle maintenance, but the peace of mind you get that this bike will never give a problem and this bike starts every time. Look at that pull. Oh my god. It is just on a whole other level, man, in terms of quality and fit and finish. It is far superior than the KTMs, than the Bajaj, than the BMW. BMW looks fancy, but the quality of that bike is not so great, I have to say. That bike doesn't deserve that price tag. The headlights are average, the intensity is very high, but the Pro is bit of an average. 5 out of a 10. The Pro, the intensity is 8 out of a 10. Everything is awesome. The braking is awesome. It has an IMU. Whenever the terrain changes, the ABS behavior changes, the braking power changes, it calculates the amount of braking that has to be given to the calipers that is given to the disc. The braking is far superior than the other competitors in this price range. I don't know why other YouTubers or other motorcycle channels, I have to say, don't mention this fact that it has an IMU for the braking. So I think for that reason alone you can pretty much buy this bike. It is very safe and the braking is amazing. The power is there. The mileage is great. It is giving me 35 of average. What else do you need? And it is available in this beautiful matte black, and there is also a red color version, and the choice is yours. Both of them look good, but this matte black has something special. So this is for someone who is looking for the KTM Duke 250 or the Dominar 250, and I am 100% sure you will be impressed by it. So that's all it from my end. I hope this one records at least. And I'm ending the video right now. make sure you hit the like button, make sure you take care of yourself and your motorcycles. Goodbye.